These are the top action cameras out right now, but which one is the best fit for you? Let's find out. This is the GoPro HERO 12 Black. This is the DJI Action 4. This is the Insta360 X3. This is the Insta360 GO 3. I'm Ben Schminke, and this is my authentic review. This video is not sponsored by anyone, so this is my brutally honest take. I am supported by you guys who use my affiliate links down in the description, so thank you. I personally use action cameras almost every single week for shooting my dirt bikes and scooters, and I'm deeply invested in a comparison video like this. I myself just want to see the results, which one is going to be the best for which scenario. To keep this video succinct, I'm going to run through the main pros and maybe some cons on each camera so we can decide which one's the best for you. Starting with the newest GoPro HERO 12 Black, released in September 2023, currently priced $400. Major pro number one, it has the best resolution and frame rate options and widest variety of controls and shooting modes over all of these competitors. It even has fun unique modes like star trails, light painting, vehicle lights, and other time lapse and hyperlapse options. It also has the highest resolution of 5.3K and 4K 120 or 2.7K at 240 FPS. Which, speaking of slow motion, here's a quick comparison of all four. Insta is kind of the weakest in slow motion here. We've only got 3K 100 FPS on the 360 camera and 1080 120 on the GO 3. The GO 3 can be kind of goofy sometimes. Check out slow motion to change aspect ratio at 90 degrees before shooting. If I go to ratio, there is nothing besides 9x16. What is going on? It's just a little goofy, these limitations. I'm really digging the 4K 120 on both the GoPro and the DJI. Funny enough, the DJI actually looks a bit sharper than the GoPro. The X3 is pretty fuzzy and poor quality, but it's the only one with locked horizon stabilization, which is cool. And the GO 3, honestly, not too bad for the little guy. And none of these are meant for pro photography, but a quick side-by-side shows that they all look pretty nice across the board, but for the best resolution, GoPro wins here. The second major pro that I'm gonna use the GoPro 12 a ton for is the new Max Lens Mod 2.0. It has an insane 177 degree diagonal field of view, which just looks crazy immersive. It's awesome for POV, first person shots. Now it's impossible for it to truly compete with the X3, a 360 camera that basically has 360 degrees field of view, but 360 has post processing needed and it takes a bit of time. The X3 has a cool single lens mode, which removes that step of reframing and processing and records like a standard wide angle shot. But in the side-by-side, super interesting, the GoPro actually wins for the wider looking shot. Plus, I'd vote that its resolution and clarity look better too. When comparing to the Action 4 in ultra-wide mode, which is 155 degree field of view, I gotta give props to DJI because this is super wide angle with zero mod needed, and that saves you 100 bucks, the price of that new Mod 2.0. The DJI looks super sharp and good quality image, nice colors and good stabilization, it's a valid option to consider. And number three for GoPro, I really like that ReelSteady processing. It basically takes the gyro data from the video file, drop the footage into their GoPro app, and it gives that magical FPV drone stabilization that looks so smooth and flowy. The DJI Action 4 actually has something similar. The app is called GyroFlow, and its results are pretty nice too. One major con to the GoPro 12, they removed the built-in GPS feature, so you can't use that built-in speedometer and other sticker overlays for your fast action shots. If you want GPS, consider the 10 or the 11. Watch my full comparison after this. Moving to the DJI Action 4, released August 2023, currently priced $400, same as the GoPro 12. Major con right there, the Action 3 launch price was $329. They used to be quite a bit cheaper, and to have those big dollar savings right off the bat, that carried some heavy weight for the DJI Action camera. But now that the price is the same, and the weights have sort of shifted. Now, pro number one, the Action mounting system uses these sweet magnets and clips to quickly and easily snap the camera in and out of mounts. For mountability, the DJI used to be the clear winner. I love these magnets and the quick snapping system on and off, jump from one to the next, super cool. However, I do wish that they gave us a quarter 20 tripod mount on here to kind of have dual options. With GoPro, well, they finally stepped it up. Not only do we have those old prongs that they take a little while to go on and off, but they fold, and we've got that quarter 20. So all my Jobies and things like that, they just easily screw on, and you can go from there. So It's maybe a tie? What do you guys think?
Number two major pro to the DJI. If high quality and clear audio is important to you, then DJI might have the best audio system. You pair the Action 4 with the DJI wireless mic kit, no dangling wires to mess with, the receiver plugs right into the USB Type-C, clip on or magnet the wireless mic with you, and now you've got sweet, clean audio recorded right with your Action shots. It's super seamless.
Check, check, one, two. This is audio recording directly into the Action 4 from the DJI wireless mic. Sounds pretty good, right?
Number three on DJI is a few miscellaneous items. It has the largest sensor, so its video will probably look the best over the others for low light and nighttime shots. It's also the only dual touchscreen here. Now, I don't use it a ton, but every so often I reach for that front screen to quick change a setting, and it's a nice to have. Second place to this is a tie. The GO 3 has a very bright flip-up touch display, so it kind of does the same thing. And the X3, well, if you're shooting in 360, it doesn't really matter which way it's facing, so you can always mount the screen towards your face, which is cool. Another thing I like is DJI offers a plug-and-play webcam mode, no app needed like GoPro requires. Moving into the Insta360 world, first with the X3, I think it's the world's best 360 action camera out right now. Release date September 2022, current price $450. The big question here is why might you want to go with a 360 camera over a standard action cam? Personally, I still grab my X3 all the time for a few use cases. Number one, reframing an invisible selfie pole. When you're capturing in all directions, you never miss the action as you can reframe, zoom in, pull out, all after the shot was already captured. It's super awesome. So like when I go ripping on my dirt bike or scooter, it's often difficult to mount an action camera and keep it out of the way or angle it right. With the 360 camera, it doesn't even matter which way it's facing as the pole will be stitched out in processing and I can reframe to that perfect perspective. And same with time-lapse and hyperlapse shots. The X3 has the best of the best in terms of stabilization. And then when editing, I can set keyframes to animate my video, pan or tilt, zoom in or out, change the angle. It's so convenient, not having to worry about setting up the perfect shot as we can fix it in post. One major con to the X3 is that durability and specifically those exposed lenses. I think it's super goofy that Insta360 hasn't designed these screw-on protective covers like DJI or GoPro has. The 360 lenses are poking out, they're exposed, easy to scratch, and very expensive to repair. Pro number two, Insta360 has the best mobile app for both the X3 and the GO 3. In my opinion, it has the most efficient user interface, it's fast and responsive to edit and create and export, it blows the DJI and GoPro apps out of the water. Pro number three, the versatility of a 360 camera might be the most diverse. Not only is it an action camera and waterproof as is, you can capture photos and video adventures, but you can partner it up with Matterport, let's say, and you can create these full building 3D scans. Then you could create a business out of that simple investment or sell Google Map 360 tours and photos. I actually have a full video going into that world, so make sure you're subbed so you don't miss it. Jumping to the GO 3, released June 2023, price currently $400-ish. Its major pro is it's super cute and itty bitty size. It's magnetic, so it easily mounts anywhere. It's crazy lightweight. So for example, I needed to get this RC car first person shot. I instantly thought to grab the GO 3. It's way faster and easier to just slap on that sticky mount on top of the car, hit record and race off. Its stabilization's really good. And even though it's not 4K, the footage looks great for social media. With the magnetic necklace, it's so easy for those hands-free POV shots. It's got that great magnetic mounting system, flip, wireless touchscreen display, lots of fun little things. It's just fun to shoot with. Now the big question is, which one are you gonna go with? Links down below. Hope this video is helpful. See you next time.